Hello, everyone. We're so excited to tell you about our work today on the Oklahoma Science Project. So my name's Kayla Chance, not Emily Kerr, but this is our team. We're all actually part of this GSAS, and most of us, all of us, are pursuing our PhDs in the sciences. I'm in the bioinformatics program.
And I'm in the biological and biomedical sciences program.
So as you may or may not know, or you may have noticed from the first presentation in this room, Oklahoma is in a crisis right now and really is in need of K through 12 education. So this is just a plot showing how much K through 12 education has been cut in the last 10 years. So that represents over $1 billion of money that hasn't been going to students in Oklahoma. And actually, if we look at the numbers right now, Oklahoma spends about $8,000 per student per year, compared to Massachusetts, $16,000 per year. Moreover, of that money that's available, $0 are specifically allocated for STEM education. And all of this funding, all these funding cuts have led to Oklahoma schools, 20% of them are closed one day a week. So they're only open 4 days a week due to this funding situation. So all of this funding cuts has led to a dramatic need for teachers in the state. So there are about 500 teaching vacancies currently in the state of Oklahoma, and they've issued over 1,400 emergency certifications, which means that educators can be teaching high school science and not have a science degree themselves. And in fact, these needs are, this has led to larger class sizes, fewer courses offered, and this has most acutely affected high school science, math, and middle school math. Moreover, so is this affecting the students? You might assume yes, and you would be correct. So this is a plot. We're scientists, I have to show the data. So this is a plot of ACT scores from 2018. In gray, you can see the national average of students across four core competencies. And in blue is the Oklahoma numbers. So they're falling behind in all four core competencies. And just to really horrify everyone in the room, only 16% of Oklahoma seniors are meeting all four of these college readiness benchmarks, and 42% of students meet none of these college readiness benchmarks. And this is in the context that Oklahoma leads the nation for STEM jobs available for workers with some college education. So, what are we gonna do?
Oh, you have. So obviously this is, I would call this a crisis, and we wanted to see if there was something we could do to try to remedy some of these deficiencies. And what we wanted to do was create a resource that could be available to students who might be interested in science, but really are not able to pursue it through their normal educational trajectory, because maybe they have teachers who don't have the appropriate expertise, or they just don't have access to materials. And so in order to do that, we wanted to create a resource that would be free, and that wouldn't require access to anything except a computer and the internet. So you don't have to be in school, you don't have to have a teacher. And so we built a website, which we call the Oklahoma Science Project, to host a couple of different things. So the first major component that I want to talk about is programming lessons. This is just a sort of an image of what our interface looks like, and if you zoom in, you can see kind of what it looks like as you're walking through these lessons. But the idea was that we wanted to create not just programming lessons, but lessons that would be sort of couched in scientific applications, so that students would be able to learn a little bit about what coding might allow you to do in the context of STEM, rather than just kind of learning coding in a vacuum. And of course, coding is itself a useful skill for trying to prepare for, you know, the STEM job market. So we've been doing some beta testing with students through several different enrichment programs. So about 10% of the students that we've worked with actually already have some experience with this particular coding language. And in general, we've been finding pretty good ratings that students seem to like the content and to understand the content pretty well. So we're feeling pretty encouraged by that. And then the other main component of the website is we have a blog. And the idea of the blog was that we wanted to create a space where Oklahomans who've successfully transitioned into STEM careers could tell their story about how, what inspired them to do that, what trajectory they took, and how they funded their education, so things that might be really useful for students in Oklahoma to know. So as I mentioned, we've currently been running these through mostly enrichment programs that, you know, are around kind of the Harvard area. But of course, what we really want to do is bring this back to Oklahoma. This is something that we're really hoping that our HILT funding can help us with. So we're really excited to have that as a resource. So we're actually currently in talks with the Oklahoma State Department of Education, as well as some Native American tribes, and in particular, we're interested in rural school districts that are kind of the hardest hit by some of these educational discrepancies. So with that, thank you for your attention. Please visit our website, contact us. We would love to hear from you.